Good morning, students. This is the presentation of an elementary school classroom in a slum. Second poem of our course, Class 12th English Core. The poet is Stephen Spender, and the explanation is presented by SK Jain, PGT English, JNB Katni. Let's begin with the first stanza. Far, far from gusty waves, these children's faces like rootless weeds, the hair torn around their pallor, the tall girl with her weighed down head, the paper seeming boy with red eyes, the stunted unlucky ear of twisted bones, reciting his father's gnarled disease, his lesson from his desk. At back of the dim class, one unnoted sweet and young, his eyes live in a dream of squirrel's game in tree room other than this. Let's try to understand this stanza. In this stanza, the poet says that there is a school in a slum area and some children are studying in that school classroom. The poet says about these children, far, far from gusty waves, these children's faces. Far, far from, here is repetition of the letter F. You can see here, this is alliteration. Far, far from gusty waves. Gusty waves means the waves of progress, the waves of advancement, the wave of well-being and cultural progress, economic, social, educational well-being. These children are away from the wave of progress. These children's faces like rootless weeds. So these children's faces are looking like rootless weeds. Weeds means useless plants, and the plants which are useless, which are considered useless, and they are also rootless, means they have no basis, they have no financial background, they have no educational background, they have no proper social background. The hair torn around their pallor. Their pallor means their pale faces. Hair torn around their pallor means the hair of the children are scattered on their faces. Their hair are not properly combed. So their hair are scattered on their faces. They are so poor that they do not comb their hair, and the parents are not able to take care of the children properly. The tall girl with the weighed down head, the paper seeming boy with red eyes, the stunted unlucky ear of twisted bones, reciting a father's gnarled disease. So here in this slum school classroom, some children are described. One of the children is a tall girl. A tall girl is sitting in the classroom and she is putting her head down, weighed down head, as if she is worried with something. She is burdened, she has some responsibilities, household responsibilities, financial responsibilities maybe. So she is sad, she is upset, she is putting her head down. Another student in this classroom is the boy, the paper seeming boy with red eyes. Paper seeming means very thin, very lean boy, emaciated boy, undernourished boy with red eyes. His eyes look like the eyes of the rats. The stunted unlucky ear of twisted bones. So there is a boy in the classroom who is stunted, means his growth is not proper. He has undergrowth, undernourished child, unlucky ear of twisted bones. Unlucky means having bad luck. Ear means the person, a successor. What he has got in his legacy, what his father has given him, twisted bones. Ear of twisted bones means his father was also suffering from this disease of twisted bones, torn bones, and the same disease has been transferred genetically in the son also. But he is doing reciting a father's gnarled disease. So in place of reciting his lessons, he is reciting his father's gnarled disease, disease of twisted bones. He is repeating it, his lesson from his desk. So in this way, he is reading something in his desk. Now at the back of the dim class, one unnoted sweet and young So there is another child, another boy sitting at the end back of the classroom, and this class is dim. There is not sufficient light inside the classroom. In this dim classroom, there is a boy sitting in the end, and he is very sweet, very young, a small child. His eyes live in a dream. So this boy is drifted, his attention is drifted, his attention is diverted to the outside of the classroom. His mind is busy in looking at a squirrel's game. What is the squirrel doing? The squirrel is playing something in a tree room other than this. Not in this classroom, but in a room, in a place inside the tree. So there is some space in the tree and the squirrel is playing there. The boy who is sitting in the end of the classroom is watching the squirrel. Now let's see some question and answer of this stanza. First question, why does the poet refer to the slum children as rootless weeds? Answer, the poet refers to the children as rootless weeds because they are pale and wan, being undernourished and ill-fed. Second question, why does the poet call a boy unlucky heir? What has he inherited? Answer, the poet calls the boy an unlucky heir because he has inherited the stunted physique, the twisted bones that are a result of being undernourished, a disease that probably is a legacy of his equally undernourished father. Third question, what is the boy at the end of the classroom doing? What is he looking? Answer, the child sitting at the back is distracted. The child sitting at the back of the classroom is distracted. His mind buzz has wandered away from the confines of the dingy classroom to the open spaces of trees and squirrels. Fourth question, what do we know from the description of these slum school children? Answer, these descriptions indicate that these children are thin, hungry, emaciated and unkempt, means dirty looking. This is because they are impoverished and deprived and caught in a web of poverty from which there is no escape. Thank you very much. Be well. Again, read the second, third and fourth stanza. Till then, take care and study carefully.